and welcome back to Space Engineers. Tonight, DVSMessiah and myself are actually going to be working on this beauty that we have been working on. It is a dropship for these drop pods, which I want to make very clear, we did not make these. They were actually on the dropship that is on the Steam Workshop, which I will give the guy full credit in the comments below. I also want to show you all what else we have to give credit for before I forget about it. This dropship, also not ours, it's more of a test to make sure it works, the hangars work properly. And these A-Wing fighters, which were made by Perfect Blinky, also not built by us, and all three of these blueprint authors will be put in the description of the video when I post it up on YouTube, so nobody yells at me. Awesome! Well, I actually have Deviated muted right now in Discord, so I'm gonna hop back on there and see what he's up to, and hopefully he spawned in. Okay, Deviated, I have done the intro. Are you into the game yet?
Yeah, I'm in the ship.
Why don't you come to the back where the hangar bays are and look what I've done.
You got a new ship?
Yeah, that I found it on the Steam Workshop. The guy that made its name is actually escaping me right now. I'm actually gonna have to go look it up so I can give him credit. And then these are Perfect Blinky's A-Wings. I just thought it'd be cool to have some fighter support.
Cool.
Oh, you know what I forgot to do? I forgot to open the lens cap to my webcam. So that's awesome. That's how my day's going. Also, since you were last on, I added a bottom part to the ship in the back, just so we would have somewhere to stick the thrusters. That's not in the way, and in here there is the two reactors, and I have a lot of it piped up, and then added oxygen to it.
Okay, we can use this as a place to put all the gyros, too.
Yeah. Also, I threw a shield generator on here and some batteries just in case something went wrong in construction and, I don't know, we spawned something to compare it and shot it or something like that. Because I know that's always bound to happen. Have the piston set up for lowering the fighters and then the transport all the way down, and then when you dock them back up, it'll pull them back up so you can walk under them if they need to be repaired or something like that.
All right.
Also got rid of two of the medical rooms and added refineries, or a refinery and a assembler.
Okay.
Because I didn't know where else to stick those.
Well, I was working in mirror mode, so everything that I was putting down was on the other side. So.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I forgot you were doing that.
So when you take things out, it's as long as we got, like, if it's just you and me, and we're working on the ship, it's just going to be two medical bays, so the other two are kind of pointless.
Yeah. Have you set in one of these new pods yet?
Nope.
You should definitely sit in one and look at the screens in front of you.
Ooh.
I know, it's fancy, right?
Did you do this?
No, those were the pods that were on that dropship. That, I need to figure out how to get those onto the screen, because the screens on the outside of this ship, too, have the, Hell Jumper, or the ODST symbol on them, too. Oh, I also added, doorways into the drop bay. On either side.
Alright.
And then I added a bunch of cryos. So you can basically have all of the drop troops in here, all of their stuff in these three cargo containers, and then to deploy, all they have to do is run through this door and get in their pod.
What are we gonna put up here?
I don't know. I was thinking about that. Maybe like a command room or something.
Might have to get the cult command console.
I've always had trouble with that mod. Like, the first time I ever tried to use it, when I put it down, it just like crashed.
Do you got the DirectX 11 version?
I think so. I'll have to go back and look at it, but I think I have that one. Have this one weird room up here that kind of overlooks the hangars, but it just has a bunch of space in it. And then we have the two other rooms up top as well. Yeah, this big weird empty room.
But I thought I was going to put this on, this was going to be like a, maybe a gunner ship area kind of thing, or, I don't know, what I had planned for it.
I don't know. Well, just, the bridge is directly above it, I think. Maybe. Yeah, the bridge is directly above it.
We could put like a bunch of monitors up and have like a Tim running or the MM master thing.
That's true. I like how there's still one random engine just freaking stuck on the outside of the ship.
This area I was going to put all the control consoles in.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. This is more of like a bridge area anyway.
We could probably put a jump drive back here.
Where the cargo containers are?
Yeah, right behind the conveyor.
About there.
Can you put another one? Can you put another one next to it?
Let's find out.
No.
No. Doesn't look. It's. I need one more space. I might be able to put one. I can put one right there.
I can put another one next to it.
I don't think so because it's. It goes to the center line. So I think two is probably going to be. Max in this room. Yeah, they can't fit another one there. There is an awkward space back here where we could stick something,
put back there.
That's a good question. Maybe an escape.
Maybe up.
Oh, sorry. Up. What were you saying?
Maybe an oxygen tank or some sort for the control area.
Not a bad idea. Also, an escape pod could fit back there.
Are we gonna have guns on it?
I guess some. Being a support ship, I guess it could use, I guess, some like anti-fighter support.
There's another spot for a jump drive of some sort.
Where? Those awkward rooms up there?
Off to the left and right up the steps.
Yeah.
But I don't know what we're gonna put in replacement for the other jump drives that we just laid down.
I don't know, maybe better leave those back there and then fill this in with something else.
Or we, if we're going to go on a planet, we might have to use them for tanks, for hydrogen tanks.
Yeah, that, we probably will need hydrogen tanks somewhere. Because the, what are they called? The fighters use hydrogen.
Oh, I see atmosphere.
Actually, I think that transport. That's not gonna fly. does have on it.
What's that?
Hang on. I will. Are you in the hangar where it is?
Yep, I'm right in front of you.
Give me 1 second. I'll show you.
Maybe it doesn't work in creative. Either that, turn it on.
Surprise, I'm gone.
Yeah, you kind of have a little silhouette there.
Oh, damn. I don't think that's going to work, though, because it's going to... It takes, two large reactors just to run the thing.
Probably better for large ships or, capital ships.
Ooh, I know exactly where I can stick that. Ship, but there is in the back.
I think that's because there, your other ship where I spawned is floating in space.
Seems like a good spot to stick that, right? Hey, find a control panel. Ship merge to it, it doesn't work.
Or other ships.
Did not know that, but I do now.
How do you turn it off?
Gotta find a button. There. Got it, okay. There's a warning on the mod page that says, please do not get out of your ship when you are cloaked. So I don't think that's really going to work with this ship. Somewhere on this thing. Factory or not? What do you think?
I think it's too small, or the ship is too small for that.
Oops. I don't know what just happened, but I went flying through the air.
That fixed. Yeah, I'm trying to find out a good spot for the gravity gen. Thank you.
be a good idea to put the large ship parachutes on here.
Yeah, but if we go down, how are we going to get back up?
That's a good question. Then it's just a permanent base. Also, have you ever used Adsmith's tank cannon turret?
No, I haven't.
It is my absolute favorite modded weapon ever now. Because the shells only use iron to create your steel plates. It's absolutely wonderful.
You gotta use MWI turret. There's a turret that the shells use iron to.
I do love shells that only use iron.
Not that I know of.
Because I was just thinking, what if you could drop a ground vehicle, too?
I would much rather have a, like maybe a small ship that houses the ground vehicle, like maybe a buggy, and put that ship inside this ship.
Instead of the fighter bay, or in place of the transport?
Definitely the fighter bay. So you can have two transports going down to the planet, one for people and one for vehicle.
Well, what if we just made the same transport, but on one version of it, there's seats in the cargo bay, and on the other, there's the buggy?
You could do that.
I am the last person you want to build a transport. My left door's not opening.
Well, you need to build a vehicle, and you need to build a transport so you can fit the vehicle inside the transport.
I'm definitely going to get these things off of the ship, or at least this one. Are you any good at building small transports?
No, I can't build small ships.
Set up the same now. Let's see. Maybe I have. I'm trying to see if I have anything in my workshop that, or in the workshop, that might help so he didn't have to build it from scratch. Encourage yourself, lose your strength, get lost in between. I feel like everyone builds large capital ships and not a lot of small ships.
No, there's some small ships, but they model a lot of commercial-based movies and games.
In the workshop for whether it's a large ship or a small ship. That would be nice. Looks like I'm building it. Boxes are aerodynamic, right?
What is?
I said a giant box is aerodynamic, right?
Yeah.
Thank you. like the last thing you ever want to hear somebody say in shipbuilding. Okay. Ship was trying to fly off on me.
Take a drink and tomorrow I will remember things. sail some rudder on the ship. Rum and beer, I'll take a drink, and tomorrow I will be hungover.
Hey, that ship will fit. Sweet.
You found one?
No, I built one. Well, the frame of one.
Now you gotta fit a buggy inside there.
Yeah. That's the tricky part. I guess I could make it a little bit wider, actually.
Well, see, the thing with that is you're using small blocks with, you're gonna have to use small blocks with the vehicle too.
Yeah.
It's gonna be a pain in the ass.
Luckily, we have a small ship mega mod pack installed.
Yay. That worked.
Nothing good can come of me working on it inside of there.
I'd just be afraid trying to use large blocks, it wouldn't fit. Thank you.
Are these vents up front hooked up to the oxygen?
Yep, all of the vents in there are hooked up to the oxygen. Should I make the thrusters hydrogen, or should I go atmospheric and ion?
For what?
For the ship to ground transports.
I would say atmospheric and ion.
Thank you. How goes the work on your end?
Thank you.
Thank you.
this thing has enough thrust.
I'm working on that now.
Oh, I was talking about the transport. The small ship one. Well, it has 16 seats in it, so...
It should be alright.
Which doesn't make much sense because there's 24 pods at launch, I think. Spell today.
Okay.
I guess if this is a to be landed on planets, I guess I need landing gears on the bottom of it. I think that might help a little bit. What do you think?
Not necessarily. You can always use the connector.
Will work for a true transport. It's not pretty, but it'll get the job done. Also, the ship is drifting.
Yeah, no, it's probably my fault.
Yeah, it might have been mine. Thing.
No, it took off one of the side thrusters.
I try to get in the ship and I fly in and then turn my jetpack off and I just drop straight through the ship. The like little transport, not the ship. Fine. think that bay is going to be big enough for a vehicle.
Maybe.
I'm trying to figure out where I'm going to stick the thrusters on this thing now. I think I could stick them on the outside and I'll still have room.
But you gotta put on side thrusters too.
That's true. But I think the side thrusters should be able to fit in these little gaps here. And face them out.
Because I'm starting to see an issue with like scaling. How the back of our bay is kind of relatively small for ships that we want to put in there.
Yeah.
But we got. We're building with small ships, so we can't really put everything inside of the small ship that we want to put in our bay.
Well, what if we... There's still room out in the front. What if it was, instead of a fit in the bay, if the vehicle itself was stuck with a merge block right on the bottom behind the drop bays. So as soon as the pods go, put some thrusters on it and have wheels, but just like enough thrust that it won't like smash into the ground. And then the ship parachutes. And then just drop it off the ship.
The big ship?
Yeah, like, where'd you go?
I'm behind the two ships.
Okay, come over to where the downward thrusters are on the big ship. Like, stick it, like, with a merge block right here. And then, the same time you jettison the pods, just drop it from right here.
I'm thinking we're gonna have to keep it like a... We're gonna have to keep a... Keep it, the big ship, as a drop ship, and forget about the vehicle.
Oh, yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm just saying the vehicle be, like, attached to the bottom, and it just drop down the same time with the pods.
I'm saying that we're going to have to forget about the vehicle altogether.
Oh.
I don't think it's going to work. I mean, not the merge block or anything, but I just, it's starting to get like too out of hand for the ship. Like we're adding too much stuff to the ship.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Because don't forget, we still have to work on the thrusters because all the thrusters are just pointing out all over the different places. Plus you got thrusters in the back that if you got damage to blocks with the thrusters, half your rear of the ship is going to wind up blowing up.
That's true. Man, let's just forget about the vehicle.
Because, I mean, it looks like a like two big doors for two shuttles going down, but we have a problem with trying to put a shuttle in the back of the ship. So either we rebuild the whole entire ship again, or we just build a shuttle for passengers going down and back up to the planet and keep the main ship in space and keep it just like it is, but straighten it out so that all the thrusters aren't like pointing all over the place. Gotta kind of fine-tune it.
Yeah, let's just do that. There's no sense for trying to rebuild the whole ship.
Because even my big capital drone ship could fit cargo ships, but it's not going to fit a cargo ship that's going to be able to house a ship that takes a vehicle down to a planet.
Yeah. Oh well.
This will work nicely.
Yeah, that's... I'm surprised. Usually my buildings don't turn out this well. And it's... If I had airtightness enabled in the world, I think this would be airtight. Got two bits up here. Actually, oh, there's a problem. Sit in one of the seats and then get out of it. It puts you outside.
Yeah, you might want to move the block in a little bit.
Now it deployed me on top. I don't think there's anywhere I can put these seats that it's not going to do that. Let's just call it a feature for rapid deployment. I think it was Rich that said it. Whenever something doesn't work right, they call it a feature.
Yeah.
Interior doors are airtight, right?
I think so.
I can never remember. Dang it, you know what I should have done? Should have built the ship the other way around. where the thrusters and stuff were on top, and the actual troop cabin was on the bottom.
Thank you. Thank you.
would you feel sitting upside down in a transport?
It's very unsafe.
Okay, then no upside down seats.
Even unsafer?
Well, I put some upside down and I was like, huh, this might work. Feels a whole lot more spacious.
Others.
Okay. There are two iterations of the transport, and they're both in the hangar. Clock update? Or did you just happen to put it at the time it was?
Do I like my LCDs?
I do. They're very nice. Oh, that clock changes time. I've never seen that. The little thing.
If we were in survival, I could have like the power show you how much uranium is in it and how much time we have on it and all kinds of stuff.
I will admit I am bad at that stuff. I'm lucky to even be able to place an LCD screen on the wall.
I'm gonna do this room and then I'll go up top and I'll try and put more important stuff up top.
By the way, where do those conveyors lead that like go outside?
Guns.
Oh.
They connect to the cargo containers in the top part of the ship in the rear. They go up top and they go into the front part with the glass, the control area, and then they go up another cargo conveyor out to a gun.
You know, I put air vents on every part of the ship except those little airlocks you made between the hangar and the interior of the ship.
You also don't have air inside the some of the rooms that we have.
Oh yeah, because we haven't sealed those up yet, that's right.
But you got interior turrets, you got lights all over the ship, you got LCD screens, and you got guns out on top. Other than that, that's about it.
Also gotta remember to turn off the gravity generators on the transports. Oops. Thank you.
Oh, and you got gyros down the bottom.
Oh, of the... Okay, awesome. Should we make an access port to get to the bottom?
I was thinking about it, but I was thinking about making an elevator going down, but I gotta figure out where I can put it.
You can put it where the assemblers are. There's one space on the side of them. I just noticed that. Other side.
The gyro there.
We can move the gyro.
Yeah, I think this will be alright. Well, you got a door, don't you?
Oh, yeah, but I'm saying, like, so that room is not connected to the entire bottom of the ship.
Because I don't think the bottom of the ship is.
Oh, airtight.
Yeah, I guess we're gonna have to.
Done. happen to have the script for airlocks, would you?
I don't think so. I might.
I've never used it before, but I know a lot of people do. Those airlock rooms are now connected to air.
I have whips, auto door, and airlock script.
Maybe that's what people use.
I've never tried it, so I don't know how it works. Gonna bring up the air from down the bottom, so I was kind of confused as to whether it's gonna work or not, because you got everything connected to it.
Could bring it up that front wall and along the side top wall of the drop bay.
I was thinking about going from the other side where the above the cryos over to here and into these rooms so that it's just one big gigantic room, and then just seal it off like that. So the drop pod bay is not going to be airtight. It'll just be the cryo room and this room.
Already airtight though.
Not with, well, it will be airtight, but if you have a vent inside that, you're just going to be wasting ice.
Yeah. Well, I was going to set the vents to suck the air, to depressurize the room. When those
cars. Well, you would have to have a separate oxygen system for that room, the drop pod room, instead of the other room, so that you can label the air vents for just that drop pod room, drop pod air vents. So you can set those to depressurize every time that the bay doors open. So you would probably have to set up a timer so that it would first depressurize, change those lights from green
to red.
To red. and then have it depressurized and then turn it back to green and then open the bay doors and then close the bay doors.
Sounds like a lot of work.
Yeah, it is. Don't worry about it.
Thank you.
Well, that was smart.
Yeah, I was trying to walk around the drop bay and jumped off the top level and just kind of fell through.
Well, I was thinking about adding two extra doors where I am.
So, like, right here?
In here. The other problem I saw was that you got the two med bays on the left and right, right after the bay. Right after the drop pod bay.
Yeah.
So you're gonna have to switch them around with the refinery and the assemblers and push them back, take the med bays and switch them.
I think they'll be fine as long as somebody pays attention to whether the door's open or not.
Well, that's why I said put the extra doors here so that if anything, it doesn't depressurize the rear of the ship because the elevators going up to the control room is not pressurized. Pressurizing the whole back of the ship. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, I guess I'll work on the two back rooms if you want to fix the two front rooms.
Okay.
assemblers did you stick in here?
5. He got 1 master and 4 slaves. You know what that does?
Makes it better.
Makes it faster. 1, if you're giving the master assembler a job to say do 1,000 steel plates, it'll split it up between the 4 plus the master.
Did not know that.
And sticking them side by side using the speed modules, it splits the, it's like 1 speed mod, or 2 speed modules are actually like 4, so they go twice as fast.
Did you put any power efficiency ones on there?
Nope. Yep. They all got, what the hell is it called? Production yield modules. Should try and put a an oxygen tank and a cryo tube in here, and we can put something else in the front.
Okay. I do love that they added that. Next time we do a live stream, can you do that in survival?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, next time we do a live stream, hopefully Dutch just doesn't watch my videos, but I'm going to do that and walk up behind her and scare the crap out of her.
I think you can. I'm not sure. I think as long as you have the skin in the med bag, it's gonna work.
I have to look at that next time I'm on survival.
Thank you. trying.
Can you put a programmable block down somewhere?
In the back, up top, in the behind the control panel, or the control section. Should be labeled LCD. Timer block should be labeled LCD too.
Oh, well, about to see if this code works.
You need a timer block.
Oh yeah, I guess I do. Thank you.
change the number of drop pods on that script.
Do you know how?
I see the spot for it, so...
Okay, well, it must not be that hard then.
Watching my FPS drop.
Thank you.
how do you get things running in programmable blocks to show up on LCD screens?
Very carefully. What are you trying to do?
Show the pod readiness on the LCD screens. Because that's what that programmable block does.
Do you know what the program does?
It should check the status of the pods.
So you got the program that was on the programmable block beforehand?
Yes.
And did you put it in the programmable block?
Yes.
I don't see it in the code editor.
Which part? The original code?
Yeah, the original code. Did you copy and paste it in there?
Yep.
Because I don't see it. Are you in the right block, or you're doing it in the drop pods, right?
Programmable block drop pods. Edit. Yeah, it shows the whole code.
Okay, your timer block is not running, so that's a problem. You don't have your timer block inside your timer block.
Oh, I thought I did
and there's a whole bunch of errors. It says mount merge block 2 is not found, skipping.
Maybe it's because the merge blocks aren't under the right name.
That might be right.
Thank you.
Does it see it now?
I don't know, the timer doesn't seem to want to work. He's using a dex panel too.
Merge 23 was not found.
You got a caught acceptance execution of script. You might have to recompile it.
Object reference not set to an instant of an object.
All right, it's bedtime for me.
Okay, I'm gonna see if if I can get this code to work for a few more minutes and then probably get off.
Well, you have a good night. Enjoy your programming.
I will not. This is as bad as working on the website that I was doing at work.
I feel your pain.
Oh well, I'll see you later.
See ya.
longer than I was expecting it to. Boop, 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 boop.
Hello, everyone. I'm happy to talk to you again after a while.
Hello.
It's been a long time since first release of configurable automatic LCD script. I never imagined it will become so popular. Right now, it has more than 100,000 subscribers. I would like to thank you all for your long-lasting support. Some of you I remember since March 2015 when the script was first released, and you keep coming back. Thanks a lot. Today, I would like to teach you how to use the new version of the script called Automatic LCDs 2. This is complete rewrite of the core of the script, which allows me to do many things that were not possible before, while being much more efficient than previous version. If you already used first version of the script, you will have no problems using this one. Since the script now has so many features, thanks to your awesome suggestions, it is not possible to cover all of them in detail in one video without boring you all to death. So, this is the basics video, where I will try to teach you the basics of the script, which are very important to understand if you really want to use the script to its full potential and avoid most problems of the beginners. Make sure that you have around 30 minutes of free time before continuing with the video. I tried to cut it as much as possible, so you get as much information in as short time as possible. So let's not waste any more time and let's get to it. After you subscribed to the script on the workshop, you will need to build two blocks, program member block and...
Thanks for watching, everyone. This has been Admiral Conrad, and big thank you to DVSMessiah for joining me, and hopefully we will get this ship and I will get these damn program blocks working. Well, I will see y'all in the next one. This has been Admiral Conrad, signing out. I don't want to exit.
space engineers is not cooperating with me today. Anyway, see y'all in the next one.
Peace!
Yeah, Rich is gonna kill me for that.